Prince Charles will visit Barbados to be there in person when the nation officially transitions to a republic and ditches the Queen as head of state. Prince Charles will visit Barbados at the end of the month following an invitation by Barbadian Prime Minister Mia Amor. The Prince of Wales will visit the Caribbean country as the next head of the Commonwealth and will be the guest of honor at the celebrations taking place to mark the nation's transition to a republican state on November 30. Clarence House announced today in a Twitter post, the Prince of Wales will visit Barbados to mark Barbados' transition to a republic within the Commonwealth. As future head of the Commonwealth, HRH has been invited by Mia Amor Motley, Prime Minister of Barbados, to be guest of honor at the Republic celebration events. While in Barbados, Prince Charles will also undertake a short program of engagements. The heir to the throne last visited the Caribbean nation in 2019. Prince Charles met Ms. Motley earlier this week during a bilateral meeting in Glasgow. They were both attending COP26, the UN's climate change summit. Both Prince Charles and Ms. Motley also took part in the opening ceremony of COP26 on Monday, during which they delivered powerful speeches. The Prince of Wales spoke about the need to involve the private sector in the fight against the most pressing environmental issues the planet is currently facing. He concluded his speech by saying, "Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, many of your countries I know are already feeling the devastating impact of climate change through ever-increasing droughts, mudslides, floods, hurricanes, cyclones and wildfires as we've just seen on that terrifying film. Any leader who has had to confront such life-threatening challenges knows that the cost of inaction is far greater than the cost of prevention. So, I can only urge you, as the world's decision makers, to find practical ways of overcoming differences so we can all get down to work together to rescue this precious planet and save the threatened future of our young people." On the other hand, Ms. Motley urged world leaders to try harder when making decisions to stave off climate change. She said, 1.5C is what we need to stay alive, 2 degrees is a death sentence for the people of Antigua and Barbuda, for the people of the Maldives, for the people of Dominica and Fiji, for the people of Kenya and Mozambique, and yes, for the people of Samoa and Barbados. We do not want that dreaded death sentence, and we've come here today to say try harder. Because our people, the climate army, the world, the planet, needs our action now, not next year, not in the next decade. Barbados, which currently is one of the 15 overseas realms recognizing the Queen as their head of state, announced in September 2020 its intention to become a republic. Over the past year, Barbados took steps to be able to ditch the Queen by November 30, which will also mark the country's 55th anniversary of independence from the UK. In September, the Barbadian Parliament unanimously approved a constitutional reform which will see the nation's citizens swearing allegiance to their country and the continuity of its institutions rather than the Queen. Speaking about the vote on the reform, Ms. Motley said it put an end to discussions over whether the country was going to achieve its full independence. She added, "This reform announced to the world we have the confidence in ourselves to be fully responsible for who we are and what we do." Last month, Barbados also chose Dame Sandra Mason to become Barbados' first president. Dame Sandra currently is the Governor General of Barbados, the representative of the Queen in the country. The last country to remove the Queen as head of state was Mauritius in 1992.